Okay, hello and welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. My name is Addie. Today's video is going to be kind of a sit down chat style video. I feel like I've never done a video like this, so I just wanted to sit down and chat with y'all, give you guys a life update. I asked you guys over on my Instagram stories for some questions that you guys might have for me, and I got a few answers back from that, so I'm gonna be answering a few of those and kind of just giving you a life update and just a few things that have been going on. I have a iced coffee. Yes, it looks like milk. I promise it is coffee. I asked for extra oat milk, but I have my coffee and we're in my car, so let's get started. I wrote down a few of the questions y'all asked and a few of the life updates that I want to give y'all. So I think we're going to start with life updates. If you're new here, I just got married almost 2 months ago. We got married in Costa Rica with 30 of our closest friends and family. It has been amazing just being back and enjoying married life. We bought land back in February before the wedding, and since then we have been working on house plans. It has taken much longer than I would have thought. I think it's kind of normal, but I was thinking that it was just going to be a super quick and easy thing. I'll put up a few pictures of our floor plan and kind of vibe we're going for. We are building a house. We are so excited. I feel so blessed that we're able to do this. So we are working with someone to build our floor plans, and just with like Florida rules and insurance and having to build a retention pond on our land, it's taking much longer to get some of these things approved than I would have thought. So right now the whole house planning, house building, all of that has kind of consumed my mind. Honestly, we haven't been doing a lot, but it's kind of all I think about. I'm just so ready to be in our house and be in a home. Right now we're living in my husband's parents' carriage house, which has been great to be able to save money, but I'm ready for just a little bit more space. And since I work at home, I feel like I'm so motivated by my space around me, and I just cannot wait to have a beautiful home that I designed and decorated to be able to do all that for. But I do know that everything comes in its perfect timing, so I'm just trusting that process. But we are hoping that in the next month the floor plans will be done. We will get all of the engineering to We'll get all of the engineers to sign off on all of the things we need them to sign off on. Some of it I don't even really understand, but we're hoping in the next month all of that will be done, and then we can start clearing the land and building, and hopefully that will take around 6 to 7 months. I've already started looking at light fixtures and cabinets and stuff like that, so thankfully we do get to start buying and purchasing some of those things soon, which will be super exciting. I want to film a separate video kind of sharing what it's been like buying land and kind of building a floor plan, what our floor plan is going to look like, and what the inside and everything is going to look like as well, all the details. I'm super into interior design, so I feel like that would be such a fun video to make and edit for y'all. So if you guys would be interested in that, just let me know. Anyways, that was kind of a ramble on the house building stuff, but that was a few of the questions, was when that was gonna be done and how it was going. So that was kind of the spill on that. Now that you're kind of caught up on where we are, let's get into the questions. I get this question all the time, but people ask how old I am. I just turned 20, April 2nd. I feel like I get this question a lot because I'm not in school and I'm married, so it seems kind of young to be where I'm at in life, but I wouldn't want it any other way. Okay, the next question is, how long have I lived in Florida and do I like living in Florida? So my family moved from Dallas, Texas about 5 years ago, and I have loved living here. I don't see myself ever leaving. I met my husband almost 3 years ago and he was born and raised here, and so his family's here, my family's here. I don't feel like we'll ever leave. I don't think he ever saw himself living here once he was older, because he did grow up here and it's a very small town. But I think once we met and thought about where we wanted to raise a family and build a home, we decided here was where we wanted to be. The next question was how me and my husband met. I kind of touched on that we met 3 years ago. We met through a mutual friend. It was kind of a God moment because we didn't it wasn't really a mutual friend. He had a friend that kind of knew my friend, and we were having a little beach goodbye party for my friend, and he ended up showing up. And then the next day I told my mom that I wanted to marry him, and he told his mom the same thing. So it is the sweetest story. I definitely want to do like a couple's Q&A, so if you guys would be interested in that, let me know. I don't know if he would do it. I mean, I know he would do it, but I just think it'd be mostly me talking because he does kind of get shy on the camera. So, but if you guys would want a couple's Q&A, let me know. The next question is kind of still on the same topic of me and my husband. It was how long we were dating before we got married. We were dating like 2.5 years before we got married. We got married back in March, and our 3-year will be August 1st or August 19th. We kind of have 2 dates. So we dated for about 2.5 years before we got married. The next question is, when do we want kids and how many kids do we want? So me and Chase have always said we would love 2 boys. Obviously, whatever God gives us, we will be so thankful for. But I have always just felt like I am going to be a boy mom, and I feel like 2 is the perfect number. Or I would do 3 as well. I feel like 2, I may not feel like I'm done with 2. So we'll just see. You never know. But definitely 2 and maybe 3 if we can. So that is the plan. Obviously, things don't go to plan sometimes, but 2 to 3, we would love that. We right now are not necessarily trying, but we're not trying. We're kind of just letting whatever happens. I would definitely love to start trying in the next year. I've always wanted to be a mom and a young mom, so I definitely feel like in the next year we'll start trying. Next question is how I got started on social media and how I got into it. A little bit of a backstory. Growing up, we visited the area where I live in now. Every summer, we would basically live here in the summer for my parents' job. So I've always loved taking beach pictures. I'll try to put up a few of my old beach photos compared to now, which is so funny. I was looking at them the other day. I still kind of take the same pictures, obviously dress better and better filters, but it is kind of funny how some things don't change. I've always loved taking pictures. My mom's a photographer, so normally I'm behind a big reel camera. But I kind of got into phone pictures about 3 years ago, and probably like 1.5 years ago, I would start posting more consistently on Instagram because we moved here full time and I really just enjoyed posting in outfits and bikinis. So I started posting more consistently. And then about 1 year ago, I would work with brands on a gifted basis. So they would send me clothes and I would post in exchange for that. And then kind of fast forward a few months when I was building up my portfolio and kind of getting my Instagram where I wanted it to be, I would reach out to brands and ask for a paid collaboration, or they would reach out to me asking for content, and with my response I would let them know my rates. And that's kind of how I started making money from social media and making it a full-time job. I'm also an Amazon influencer, and that's how I make a lot of my income. If you guys want a separate video on how to get started on social media, just let me know and I can do that for y'all. But I also just launched an influencer 101 guide. I'll put up a few pictures on what will be in the guide. It's on sale right now for $9.99. I'm probably going to keep it at that price for about 2 weeks. It was originally $20, but for the first 2 weeks of it being up, I wanted to give it as a discounted price for y'all. So if you guys are interested in that, it will be linked in the description or in my bio somewhere. And included all of the things that I say to brands. So my brand pitches, what to include in a media kit, some of my favorite tips on creating content for good lighting, poses, planning your feed, and promoting yourself on all different platforms. So there's a lot of good information on that. So if you guys want to check it out, just check out the description down below and I will leave it there for y'all. Okay, I've just been talking, so I keep forgetting to drink my coffee, but I need to do that. Okay, the next question is, what is my morning routine like? I have a few videos that I posted of my morning routine and kind of a day in the life, but I normally try to wake up and go to some workout class or the gym. And if the weather's good, I love going to Sunrise. Right now it is literally at like 5:30, so I can't get myself to wake up that early, but I think I'm gonna go this weekend. But in the summer, it gets a little bit later, so I'm not waking up at the crack of dawn. But I normally do a sunrise if I can, the gym, and then I try to go to a coffee shop and work or film at home. If I'm doing try-on hauls or computer work, I'll probably just stay at home. And then I make lunch and try to plan to do something fun. Chase gets off work around like 5, so normally when he gets off, we try to have a little date or hang out with our friends. So that's kind of like a day in my life, I would say. I love going to the beach. The weather's been so nice, so we try to go to the beach as often as we can. But yeah, the next question is my favorite places to get breakfast and coffee on 30A. I swear I'm always at a coffee shop. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that I'm always out and about getting coffee or doing work at a coffee shop. So I will put a little screenshot of my favorite places, but number one will probably be Fonville. I love their coffee. Their food is so good, and the whole vibe of the coffee shop is my favorite. I love Ron Juicy. They have the best avocado toast. Holiday and Alice has the best coffee. I've never got food from there. I think they just have like grab and go stuff, but they have the best lattes. Black Bear is another one of my favorites. They have the best atmosphere for working and such good avocado toast. I'm a sucker for avocado toast. So those are probably my top four favorite breakfast and coffee shops on 30A. Gotten a lot of questions on things to do on 30A and a few questions on where to stay, if you should rent a car or if Ubers are good, if dogs are allowed. I've gotten a lot of questions on what it's like on 30A. So I think I'm gonna make a separate video, like a 30A guide. I have a 30A guide on my Instagram. It's like a feature on Instagram that you can make a guide, and I have a few of my favorite places on there linked. But I definitely want to make a full 30A guide. So if you guys are interested in that, let me know as well. I've gotten a few questions for that, so just let me know. Yeah, last question is going to be my favorite places I've traveled and any travel plans coming up. So my most recent favorite travel is definitely Cabo. We went for a little pre-honeymoon. We kind of just call it that because we went the week before our wedding. It was just kind of the time that worked to go. We went with my grandparents, so it was such a special time. My parents have had a timeshare there since I was like a baby and before I was born, so it's so special to be able to go back because I haven't been back for a very long time. So that was such a fun trip. We also were in Costa Rica for 2 weeks for our wedding, and that is probably my favorite trip out of the whole year. We go every spring break, and I just love that place so much. And now that we got married there, it has such a special place in our heart. And then last November, me and Chase went to the south of France, and I loved it so much. It was definitely on the chillier side, so we didn't get to swim, and we didn't have that whole like European summer that everybody post about. So I definitely want to go back when it's warmer out and we can swim, but that was such a fun trip. We were there for like 10 days. We had so much fun just exploring, going to museums, and kind of just traveling around and seeing different places, and all of the old buildings was just so cool. We've been traveling a lot recently on some bigger trips. So right now we have a few like road trip plans. We're going to North Carolina with my family like we do every year to stay with our friends, and then probably down to South Florida, and then I would love to go out west on a little road trip, but we are from Florida, so that's very far. We have family in Texas, so we might drive, stay there, and then do it after that, so we'll see. But I would love to do that. I think right now, since we are building the house, we're just gonna focus on that and then hopefully travel after that. That's all for today's chat and Q&A with me. Thank you so much for watching up until this point. If you're still watching, if you guys want a part two or have any questions for me, just leave them down below. I'm going to link all of my other socials if you guys want to check that out, because I share more day-to-day life on Instagram and TikTok. I'm trying to upload to YouTube 2 times a week, so definitely subscribe so you don't miss any of those videos. But for now, that's all I have for y'all. Bye.